Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Lecture Notes. So today I'll be explaining a poem, Wild Lemons, which is written by David Meloff. So before starting with the lines, I would like to tell you about two things. That first, past of Australia, and secondly, past of the writer. So past of Australia, as you all know, Australia being a country which is surrounded by water, and it was discovered by Captain James Cook, who was a British explorer and found Australia, and then British colonized it. The natives faced a lot of changes and somehow suffered a lot. Like India was also colonized by Britishers and had suffered a lot. Similarly, Australia had its own struggles while British colonized it. Secondly, about the author, that he is an Australian writer who has traveled a lot, and while he was in an alien or a different country, as soon as he had a drink which had a lemon in it, he thought about his own country and it made him nostalgia. Thirdly, I would like to tell you about the lemon. What is wild lemon basically in this poem? Lemon is tough from outside and tastes same in every country, that is sour. That it looks same, though the size might differ, but it looks same, that it is yellow in color and it has a same flavor in every country, that it is sour. So basically, the wild lemon symbolizes Meloff's Australian homeland, that no matter an Australian travels many countries or settles in any part of the country, his identity cannot be changed. Similarly, a lemon can be found in any country, but its identity, its taste, its color doesn't change. Similarly, the Australian identity cannot leave a person. Wherever one person travels, the taste, his things remain same. The environment might change, he might change with the time, but his basic crux cannot change. So moving with the lines, through all those years, keeping the present open to the light of just this moment. So this moment, that refers to when he was having a drink and he discovered the same tangy taste of lemonade. So years, keeping the present here refers to keeping the past in the present, not detaching himself from the past, that he is nostalgic about the past. He tries to reconcile the past with the present. What is his past? That he thought about his native land. So all those years, keeping present open to the light of just that moment, that as soon as he sipped the drink, he thought about all those years he had spent in his native land. That was the path we found. You might call it a promise. That starting out among blazed trunks, the tracks would not lead nowhere. That being said, so in the third line, he tells that we were moving, the reference path we found, that we were moving on a path and we knew exactly where we were going. Therefore, the path has been referred to promise. That the path we find, you call it a promise because they were aware of the path and knew that while going forward, they will find lemons, that in the end of the path, they will find lemons. In the rugged terrain of tree trunks, weathered by years of intense sunlight and heat, held a promise of bright future, a happy destination. The track obviously leads to the place where the wild lemons grew. So in the fifth line, he has mentioned the two negative in one particular sentence. The track would not lead nowhere, not and no, which makes it a positive sentence, that he knew exactly that in the end, what will be the result? It will be a positive result because it is a terrain of lemons, and in the end of the terrain, they will find the wild lemons. Down here among wild lemons, our bodies were expected at an occasion up ahead that would not take place without us. So in the first paragraph, he mentioned that exactly where he was going. And secondly, he does mention that what in the end they are going to see, that are the wild lemons. And then he says that our bodies were expected there as if it was a place of secret communions with nature, where body comes first and then comes the insight or the mind. Similarly, he knew about his past, but he came to realize about his past when he was somewhere else, or with the passage of time, he realized his past. or a burial place where body comes first and then comes the soul. Whenever we go to a place, our mind might be absent, but physically we are always present. Like in every online or offline class, our mind might be absent, but physically we are there. Similarly, he says that he was physically in his past present, but mentally he is now aware about the Australian past that was in the history and what he had faced, what his natives had faced. One proof was the tough-skinned fruit among their thorns. Someone had been there before us. Tough-skinned fruit has been referred to lemon, and someone has been there before us, that his ancestors, the presence of ancestors was there before he traveled the path. So he's making it, he's referring to colonizers also, that the colonizers established and colonized Australia as if it was no man's land. But the nature is a proof that his Australian native people were already there and it was not a no man's land. So how a lemon acts a symbol or a thing through which he remembers his ancestors or ancestral land. The toughness of the fruit from outside highlights how Australians native were tough when they were colonized by Britishers. And the Britishers might be successful in colonizing the land, but could not colonize or control the nature as well as the hearts of nature. Like the Australians were growing as a natural fruit and they could not control the emotions and their mental ability. Though they might have colonized them physically, but mentally they were one strong unit. And they could not have a complete control over their mind and how their identity remains similar with the passage of time, no matter how much control they were in. And planted these, their sunlight to be sliced for drinks. They had adapted in their own way and to their own ends. So now the lemon has been compared to the sun. So sun symbolizes new day and new hope. Metaphorically, lemon has been compared to a sun because of its physical appearance, but it also shows how lemonade is a refreshing and a new drink. They have adapted in their own way and to other end, referring to the lemon that now they are growing in every part of the world. Similarly, Australians have also settled in every part of the world, but their identity is something which hasn't changed. They might have adapted the environment, they might have changed themselves according to their surroundings, but their basic crux, that is lemon, is sore, and similarly Australian identity cannot be detached. Like the sun has seen everything, so has the wild lemons, that is nature is something which is constant. The wild lemons have adapted themselves to various climes and times and have survived through the ages because it's a part of nature. Also implied that human may change with time, but nature doesn't like the taste. But nature, like the taste of lemon, no matter where it grows, it doesn't change with time. So again, lemon being compared to sunlight, that how nature doesn't change, it might adapt. Similarly, humans might adapt, but their basic crux, their soreness, the lime taste, it doesn't change. Another was the warmth of our island, sitting still in its bay at midnight humping. Now he's geographically explaining or exemplifying his island, that how his island has the warmth of the sea because Australia surrounded by the sea. And he's thinking about the past, that how he was sitting at the bay and the sounds of the waves were humming at the midnight. So the poet's thought traveled towards his beloved country, that is Australia, which is surrounded by water of the ocean. Sitting still at the bay, the poet describes its warmth as if there were a living, breathing entity humming and rising to the concerns of its country people. So now you'll say that the bay, the sea has been, in the further lines, will be described as humming, talking, and showing its concern. So here sea has been personified and rising to its own concerns, but back heat struck leaped by clean ocean waters at dawn. So here the sea is showing that it is humming, showing its concern, personification. And here, Miloff has beautifully described the geography of Australia, that how it is surrounded by water and how beautiful it is. So he describes his country that there is a lot of heat, but clean and clear atmosphere at dawn, where water is chilly. The presence is always with us, always open. So he says that no matter where he travels, the present is always with us. That present is something that is always with us. Open here has been referred to freedom. That is, the present he and his native land is free, while things are different, were different in the past. Always open. Open means freedom. That earlier they might have been colonized, physically, mentally oppressed, but right now their future is open, their present is open. That in the present they are open to do, they are free to do anything they want. Though to what out there in the dark, we are making for us seven for se- making for as 7 o'clock. From day to night highlights how nature and time are few things that follow the same path. While the nature of humans are always unpredictable. So the nature follows the same path. Sorry, the nature is unpredictable. It doesn't follow the same path. While the human has to, human cannot tamper with the time and he has to flow with the time. So clearly the mention 7 o'clock, that human has to move on with the present and he always has to take notice of the time. Strikes the gin, goes down and startling gather, who can tell? Compacts made of silence as a flute tends out a flow, reluctant starts to water over the water. So earlier he was talking about Australia. Now at present he is talking about the place where he is having a gin in which the lemon is used. It is a cocktail in which a lemon is used. And then he is talking that how peaceful this land is also. There is silence which highlights the peace. And then there is a flute temps. Then there is a flute. Someone is playing flute, which is also a relaxing atmosphere. So now he describes his new lifestyle, the nature around him. The lemons too are now adapting to their own ends and in an island set its own rhythm. The wild lemons are now served with gin and tonic. Things and people change with time and environment, but their basic crux don't change. So now he is enjoying the same soreness of the lemonade, but in a different drink, different atmosphere, and everything is different around him, but the basic crux, the soreness of lemon and his identity doesn't change. I lie down in different weather now through the same body, which is where the rough track led. So he says that I'm in a different weather, different surroundings, and everything has changed, but my body, my identity cannot be changed. The same body is in an alien land where nature delights his sense and make him nostalgic. The present too is always transforming, unlocking unknown futures. So the poet travels back to past again and again, no matter the last few years were rough and hard. So you will see that in every paragraph, within every five lines, he is nostalgic about his past and he thinks about his homeland. Our sleep is continuous with the dark, or that portion of it, that is the this day's night. The body tags along as promised to see what goes. So he says that human body shaped in mind, that it works with the times, it works with day and night, while on the other hand the nature doesn't work in such way. Human body works in such a way that it has to notice time and work according is something. Then he says that our sleep is continuous, and what we lose is time. The passage of time is unstoppable. That how human is conditioned to work according to time, he works according to day and night, while nature is something which is constant, and day and night and time doesn't hold upon the nature. Like lemons have unchanging identity, remains specific in color and taste no matter where it grows. Similarly, no matter how far a human travels and change his lifestyle, his roots will remain in his native land, which cannot change. His identity will always be linked to his birthplace. The underlying meaning is identity can never be changed. What goes in time and clouds melting into tomorrow of our breaths. A scent of lemons run wild in another country, but smelling always of themselves. Smelling always of themselves highlight that how they can change everything around themselves, their surrounding, their atmosphere. They themselves can be changed with time, with passage of time, but their identity cannot be changed. So while Myelov objects to his work being seen in any way representative of gay identity as a reflection of Myelov's own sexual orientation, several of his poems, including Revolving Days and Wild Lemons, can be read in relation to sexual politics and a discourse of body that is present in these poems. So I have interpreted this poem in the form of political identity, that how he longed for his Australian homeland and how he is nostalgic about his past land, while on the other hand, lemons act as a link between his homeland and how identity does not change. But you can also interpret this poem in how one can discover his gay identity, and no matter how much he travels or whatever he does, the gay identity cannot be concealed and it is something which will remain. So I have only interpreted in it political work. So thank you for watching this video. Do like, subscribe my channel.